follow and operate in spiritual authority, we have to do what the command he left us with. Go into all of the nations, right? Making disciples. Discipline people. Mature people, right? Discipline, disciples. Those who know the gospel. Those who know Christ. Those who know his love. Amen? Now, I made a statement this morning in a meeting I had, and I was like, well, you know, I can't remember how I put it. Must have been the spirit, right? But either way, I said, listen, you're not godly. And I told him, look, everybody looked at what? No, you're not godly. I was telling him, you're not godly. How do I know you're not godly? Because you don't operate in love. Because the Bible said that God is love. Yes. And if you're loving the right way, how he said to love, not in your own twisted way. Yes. I only love you if you do something for me. I only love you if you come through for me. That's not love. Amen. That's taking advantage of somebody. You see? So when you operate in love, then you're a godly person. Watch this. See, because the Bible said he's love. The Bible never said that God is faith. It didn't say he was praise and worship. He said inhabit those things. He said he rewards faith. But he said God is love. So if I love the right way, then I'm a godly person. Then I can have things happen in my life because he's watching me. And that just don't happen for everybody else. Amen? If you get your love right, you can get your life right.
Amen.
Amen.
I mean, I had wrote that down. And I said, you know, because I don't know why it came up in the meeting like that, but it just did, and you know, and I think I was talking to more myself than I was, you know, the person I was talking to, amen?
Amen.
So watch this here. Now, let's look at some things about a spiritual authority, right, that he commanded us to do. Number one, spiritual authority is God himself confirming his word of truth with the power.